Artificial intelligence. No matter where you go, you seem to hear about it nowadays. But what exactly is AI? What can you use it for? And more importantly, how does it work? In this video, we'll answer these questions along with explaining how we implement AI at Klippa. So let's start with the basics. What is artificial intelligence and what can it be used for? Artificial intelligence, or AI, is a term used for machines that are capable of intelligent tasks, as opposed to human intelligence, often developed by finding patterns and or logic in big piles of data. Use cases are endless, like Google auto-completing your questions, helping medical professionals make the right diagnosis, self-driving cars, generating content with tools like Chat-GPT, winning a game of chess, and many more. At Klippa, we use AI for intelligent document processing, meaning we can extract data from many different documents like invoices, receipts, identity documents, bank statements, price tags, and many more. Sounds great. So how does it work? In most cases, AI uses existing data to find patterns and logic. A common way to do this is via what's called data annotation. Data annotation is a process of labeling things you want the algorithm to recognize within your dataset. This can be done by specialized teams, self-learning algorithms, or by having millions of users select pictures with traffic lights to prove that they are not a bot. At Klippa, for example, we've annotated countless addresses on invoices, so our algorithm can now recognize an address no matter where it's located on a document, simply because it has the characteristics that make it look like an address. Here it is very important to have diverse training data to prevent biases and generalization mistakes. For example, an object recognition AI labeled a video of a goat as being, well, a goat. But when someone picked the goat up, it was suddenly labeled as a cat. Why? The algorithm had never seen a goat being picked up during training, only cats. So it stopped looking at the characteristics that made it a goat and instead labeled it as a cat, since from the AI's perspective, all animals picked up by humans are cats. While we've never had a receipt being classified as a cat, at Klippa we always make sure we have a wide range of diverse training data in terms of language, image quality, and format. If we only use German receipts and English invoices, for example, we could accidentally teach our model that all German documents are receipts, instead of looking at the actual characteristics of the document. Luckily, because our clients already share documents from all over the world with us, you can get started without running these risks. Okay, so we have a diverse set of annotated training data. What happens next? The algorithm looks for patterns in both text features, so the actual words, and image features such as position, size, color, and shape. A bicycle is two circles connected by a triangular frame. A passport document number is a combination of letters and numbers located in a top right corner. And that big, prominent number after the word invoice tends to be an invoice number. Over the years, we have trained our AI models extensively with broad sets of data to be able to extract data from all kinds of documents in many different languages, helping our clients to automate tasks like bookkeeping, KYC, expense management, customer onboarding, capturing in-store data, and many more. Just like humans, AI is not perfect and always has new things to learn. That's why at Klippa we offer the possibility to include human in the loop. This means a human checks the results of the AI when the confidence score is below a certain threshold, certain information couldn't be extracted, or another rule is triggered. So that's the basics of what AI is, what it can be used for, and how it works. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful and leave a comment below if you have any more questions. Are you interested to learn more about what Klippa's AI-based solutions can do for you? Head over to our website, book a demo, or get in touch.